This is my letter to gay America. Since when has a 26-inch waist, brittle bones, exposed rib cage, flipping through every page of how to be gay, telling me what I need to say, how I need to sway, the shape I need to stay, and how my motherland is the bay, then the lifestyle I need to live. We say don't segregate us, yet we separate us into groups and cliques like who's betch and who's bitch, playing dating games with no names, just have sex and then switch. If it ain't Abercrombie and Fitch, then you can't get with this. Please, ditch the egos, because tricks are for kids, and I sure in hell don't want to be seeing you in the morning. You choose misery over history, too blind to see repeats rocking rainbows and gay pride, but have no clue of what it means, and a hole is between us and progression. Yet we keep taking backward steps in a forward direction, forgetting what we stand for, trading in positive role models for HIV positive man whores, trading STDs as if they're Pokemon cards labeled top, bottom, or verse, stuck in reverse while we rehearse the same shit. While they march for gay dick, I march for gay kids, ready to call it quits because this fucked up life they think they need to live. And I've already smoked death in the breath of meth token smokers, choking while joking about what's best with this lifestyle. And if only you could see who had to bleed for us to live this life now, then maybe you would perceive me as a fact and not a fag. Leaving bad habits stopped, I'd sing another dead faggot drop. Can you not hear me, gay America? I can see you bleeding from the mouth as you bite your lips. Be careful, it's my blood that drips once those words come out. I'm coming out. Closets are meant for skeletons, so why aren't you in one? You say you're not a skeleton, but my friend, you've been one to me since you conformed to perform this act of stereotypical madness. And it's sad that the word fag slips through lips looser than yours as they disgrace my place in civilization. Can somebody please change the station before I'm brainwashed into thinking I live under one god in this nation? It's bad enough that I'm fucked again from Republicans telling me it's a sin for me to have a love for men, but to see my friend feed to them the same bullshit that the media spins? Can someone lend me some queer eyes for the straight lies projected in the images injected into closed minds, and it's only behind shut doors and closed blinds where it's okay to be gay? Fuck that. I'll lead my own march to the White House so it's also part of my house under the rules of don't ask, just tell troops. And trust me, I don't dangle from trees, so don't dare call me fruit. I'm warning you. My juices are ruthless, and I guarantee that one bite of me will leave your fake smile toothless, but I don't want to do this. I don't want to be a soldier, but I was drafted since birth, and they tell me that it's a choice. So are they saying they once had feelings for him, but instead chose her? Because it's war that I'm forced to fight with no voice against politicians and churches that leave my people in hurts like we're worthless. Gay America, listen. We shouldn't be branded by labels and campaigns popping bottles of champagne while our own demise is the one leading our lives, and it's the white-collar million-dollar holders that are tripping when they see change. So we flip coins and only see the back of heads. Why? Because we're too focused on material things, hot boys, and dead presidents. Gay America, listen. If you don't, then who will? Because I know for a fact that it won't be Barack Obama or Hillary Clinton. Fuck you, gay America. I'm done with this mission. America, please, open your ears. Listen. Let's go.